Hi, welcome to our channel again. I'm Sheetya Sundaram. This video is about some of the homeschooling things that I absolutely love. As mentioned before, I'm homeschooling my 3-year-old son this year because of the COVID situation. And here are some of my favorite things that I'd like to share with you. Obviously, when I started this, I downloaded the most basic pre-K curriculum. Out of this, here are some. It's got math, it's got literacy, language, it's got art, it's got science. I'll share the link for this below. Okay, here goes. Here are some of my most favorite things. I initially bought this book so that he'll get a better hold of the pen. He loves this book. It's called Tracing Trails. And we've been going over it at least 2 or 3 times. We've gone over, mazes is his favorite thing. He loves mazes. We've gone over it a couple of times. He's improved so much on his pencil holding skills just with this. We've gone over each of them at least twice or thrice. Now we've gotten to tracing slanting lines. Yeah. Now, yeah, we're getting to the tracing part. This book is absolute fun. My son loves this one. Next, when I found this book, I also found these two books. This one is for math. They're same and different under the math in the pre-K curriculum, if you see it. We love writing, and this is all about drawing circles. We love to draw circles. If you see, we've been doing good with this. He's learned to identify same and different objects. As you keep going through the book, there are so many things that you have to pay attention to the details. Like I'll show you this one, where he's learned to group things. He knows that this is the same group. And he's also learned to pay attention. Oh ma, this is missing a spoon. He pointed that out even before I showed it to him. So he's learning a lot from this book. I would highly recommend this one as well. And the next one is, this comes under art in the pre-K curriculum. And Sharon loves this book. It's all about cutting and sticking. So he's got his own glue stick. He's got his own pair of scissors that he loves to use for this book. Every time we open this book, he goes and grabs them. He loves this. We try and build stories for each and everything, like how the panda got hurt. We build stories around it. And then they're same and different as well. Coloring, same and different. And this book was fun for him. He loved it because it wasn't just about writing and getting things done. He had more hands-on. He cut things, he stuck things. And the best part is they have at least a couple of pages of stickers in here. He loves it. This is his most favorite book out of all the three. Along with this, I bought this because a pencil was too thin for him. And I bought this off Target. I'll give you the link. This was so much more easier for him to hold because it was a little more thicker. He holds this a lot better than initially. This is a good buy. And then bought this. I love this. Considering English wasn't our language, and when I bought this, it took us a while before we got a hang of it. But now even if he's not able to identify a word, he knows what's in it. Just by looking at the picture, he's able to frame the sentence. So at least for us, this was a great buy. Now every time he sees something, he always adds "and" now. He's getting so much better with this. This is our absolute favorite. We just do this for fun. I even take it with me in the car and we go over it. It's fun. We just have fun with this one. The other things that recently I bought were these. I bought these off Amazon, and we just go over these before we go to bed. This is Colors. He knows all of this by now. We're done with this. Opposites. This is my favorite and his favorite because we have a lot of actions, and then we pick up toys and we say this is smaller than that one, this one's big. This is fun. Oh, months. Now we initially went over them slowly and now he knows. Now we've gone one step ahead and then we've started pointing out this is the month of his birthday. This is the month of his brother's birthday. We've been doing great with this. Days of the week. This he knows thoroughly. We've started pointing out this is today. So what was yesterday? It was this one. What's tomorrow? It's this one. We like this a lot. Shapes. He's been doing well, except for some of these are still new. Some of these are still new. We go over one new shape every day. Like, these are a little advanced for him. He knows a cube. And we've just started a pyramid. He knows a cone. We're going slowly. We do try one new shape either a couple of days once or something like that. It works well for him. Pointing it out and trying to relate it with something does help a lot. He loves this. He's learned his seasons, he's learned them, and then we try to relate it every time we go out. I try to point out it's summer because all the trees have its leaf just like in the picture. He likes it a lot. My son is the absolute weatherman now. He keeps going out and then he says, even if he sees a couple of clouds, he's like, Ma, it's cloudy. And if he sees no clouds or if he's to squint his eyes to see through, he says, it's sunny. So he's gotten better. And even the other day when there was a storm, he was able to say it was stormy. So he's an absolute weatherman now. This is fun. This is fun because we do sounds with it. Along with learning the animals, we also do the sounds with it, so it's pretty fun. This, I think, was my biggest challenge. It still is. We're still working on this. We know 1 to 20 thoroughly, and 21 is a little challenge because we're getting there slowly. So what I started to do is I started showing him 10, 20, 30 first. The way we get this, and once we get 20 thoroughly, I thought then I will move on to 21, 22, and then 31, 32. So for now, I'm working on this part. I'll let you know how it goes. Numbers. We're slow on counting. We're taking it slow, but we can count up to 3 easily. 4 gets a little challenging. We easily go over to 5. So we're taking it slow in counting. Alphabets. We're good with alphabets. We're still learning the smaller ones. We're not able to identify a J yet because it's a little confusing when you compare with the I. But we're taking it slowly. But I really love these because it's a good activity for us to go over in the night before we go to bed. And then it's a bedtime story and then we're off to sleep. These are all I wanted to share with you. Please let me know if you like it. I will add all the links to these. Let me know how you like them. Thank you. Bye.